Thank you. And I want to read Psalm 22, 9 to 11. Psalm 22, 9 to 11. It says, but he took me out of what? God is the one who, I've been telling you, your parents didn't create you. Your parents gave birth to you. But it was God who did what? Created you. And the one who created you is powerful than just the parents who give birth to you. What you can do for your parents after you are grown, you say, honor your father and mother. Two things. Which means, honor means give them gifts. They are growing, 89 to 100. They are about to die, 200. So start honoring them before they go. When they are old, 180 to 100. Honor them means give them gifts. Honor the man of God, woman, honor. He says, but do what? Apart from your spiritual parents, that one is different. But he said, your parents, do what? Honor your father and your mother in Exodus 20 or Deuteronomy 5, so that your days on this earth may do what? May be prolonged. And the reason you honor them is to have long life from them. That's giving to the parents for you to. You can't get long life from God. You get a long life from
your parents. You give to them.
So if I have trouble with the parent, go ahead and settle them and make a with them. Call them on the phone and say, I'm sorry for my behavior last time. Unless maybe into brackets. That one you should wait. You made a profitable before you go. I understand. So best time. So it's God who has been taking care of you from your mom's breast. He gave the milk into the breast and then you suck it till you grow. It was God who did it. It's not your mom. So Mother's Day and Father's Day, do it for your parents, all right, but do it more for all. And then he says, I was cast upon thee after he came out of the womb. He was what? He or she was what? Cast upon God. As far as you were born, and your mother felt you small. In that process, you were cast upon God. Right now, you are grown. Your parents cannot be responsible too much about you. So, it is between you and who? God. Not between you and your parents. So, don't be bitter about them. They have finished their work. Because since from 18 going, now you are yourself. They may mountain you and guide your rights. But you need to think by seeking this God to get away. Say, apply your heart in wisdom. Seek him to have wisdom, to live. God, they have finished their work. Because you have grown from 18 onwards. So the first person you need now, second person, your spiritual parent, God, as your father. He says, I was cast upon thee from the womb, thou art my God, from my mother's belly. And let's continue with this one. 2 Corinthians 9, 6-9. He says, but this I say, Paul said, he which so what want to go.
This I say, he which soweth sparingly shall reap also sparingly, and he which soweth bountifully shall reap also bountifully. Yes, continue.
Every man according to his purpose, so that he
not grudgingly
all
his
riches,
for all thou that shall forgive.
Continue, want to go. So you keep it with him. We are not doing fundraising here. We are just interpreting you shall be what?
Amen.
From a different perspective from the Holy Ghost. You shall be made fat. That's another language from you shall be what? So give. God loves what? A cheerful giver. It's God. So when you are doing for men of God or your parents or church, don't do it grudgingly, because you're not doing it for anybody. Who? God. Second person is yourself. You are doing it for God and then yourself. They may thank you, oh, thank you for your tithe or your offering. No, you are doing it for God and yourself. You honor God then, and then you help yourself. So don't say, I'm doing too much, I'm helping him, now he's dressing. No, you are doing it for your own self, your children, and your future. Come on. Number one, a generous person will prosper by his giving to God's work. Number one, a generous person will prosper. Talk about water, because if you give, you will also be watered. Like if you are giving me one Ghana every month, I'll feel to pray for you. So once I only give to you, is that how you are a minister? Eh? So you have this natural love for the person. And you want to, you pray for the, always pray for the person. But if you give to him and your tata, the whole world, you will stop thinking about the rest of the world, only him. So he came down to Solomon. He said, Solomon, what do you want me to do for you? Normally, we have to tell God that I need this. Because he gave big sacrifice. He said, Solomon, what do you want? Because you are giving too much. The whole time gave, but yours was extra. He came down, Solomon. He said, I don't need anything but wisdom to rule your people because they are many. So, wow, you didn't ask me a long life to kill your enemies. But okay, I'll give you a long life, kill your enemies, but I'll also give you wisdom. So number one, a generous person will prosper by his giving to God's work. Number two, you would be refreshed whenever you refresh others. Do it. When the time comes, you would be refreshed whenever the time, whenever you do what? You refresh others. It means that people may give to you and give to you. A time comes, you do. You may not give to the same person, but another person. It's like that. People may give to you, you are receiving. You don't give. They are prospering, you know, because they are giving to you. And you too must also find another person and give at least one person. How you will be watered every day, rain will come on you, your business, your company, your vision that is in you is coming alive to prosper. That is why I'm telling you all those things, so that you learn this wisdom from above. Number three, God tests, you add S, God tests the hearts of men. Hearts, S. Test, S. God tests the hearts of men. As we give and give and give, he's testing us, whether we are doing it grudgingly or we are doing it out of love, because he doesn't need our money, but just wanted us to express obedience to him through tithe and offering or whatever, or giving. You shouldn't think that you are doing it for a man of God. No. Number four. I've given you number three, right? Number three is God tests the hearts of men. Number four, God is always pleased with integrity. Picking from all the quotations I've given to you, the four quotations I've given to you, I'm giving you this point. Number four, God is always pleased with integrity. You should remain faithful to him, and the faithfulness turns into what? Integrity. Integrity is something that you can't see with your eyes. But God said that for more than 30 years, 20, 10 years, you have been consistent, and it becomes what? Integrity between you and God. You can't see with your eyes. God is the only God who sees that you have that bond with him. Number four, God always pleased with integrity. Number five, give to God willingly and with honest intent. Give to God willingly, talking about you shall be made fat, you shall be wanted. Give to God willingly. It could be small. Giving is not big or small, it's the heart. The heart was willing to give. That's why I've been giving. It's not billions. You may give billions, but the heart is unclean. And we don't give coin. And Jesus acknowledged the widow. But those who gave in essence, so this one, they are much somewhere. They are doing show. Because that with the widow, what her life depends upon is what she gave all. At the point is the heart. That's where you'll be wanted all the time. Give to God. Give to God willingly and with honest intent. Be honest to God and yourself. Intent. Number six, giving willingly, V-I-N-G. Giving willingly to God brings an everlasting joy to you. Giving willingly to God brings an everlasting joy to you. You need to do something to God wherever you are so that you have that joy. But if I'm standing here, it's chapter that has changed me. It's not fasting and prayer. They are all involved. But mainly, if you see physically, is a tithe that has changed me. It's a tithe that has changed this room. I take the check tithe to somebody and also pay my tithe. It's working. So I'll do it. More what am I? Glorify you and give you glory. Yeah. There's a snake that wants to enter your yard, because your yard has become a bush because of the farm you have created there.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Your yard is a bush there. Tomato, garden eggs. And there's a small hole under the gate is brown. A small hole under the gate. And they want to manage to come. There's a small bush at the top there.
It's true.
So you need to get some money and do what they call it. Mess the cement in front of the gate so that you can close the gap.
Yes, sir.
It's like when you open the gate, either you open the gate out or here, whichever way you may do, so that you block it, so that they don't enter.
Yes, Daddy. One entered, we killed it.
The anointing that we have been pouring on you has beautified your face. The manicure, pedicure, or the orchicure. So thank you very much for dressing well and being holy. And I watch the video. If you're holy, I will know. It's just your face I want. And may God bless you for keeping yourself neat. So maintain it. And I saw you standing all in white and dancing when the singers were singing. That's good. That's beautiful. And you are happy now. The pride has left you. You have become like us, humble. Mm-hmm. Physically, you need to be like a lamb or dove, but inside you a lion. That's how it should be. So that if outside is a lion, nobody can approach you. The lion must be inside, and outside should be a lamb or dove, so that people can get close to you. But when they try you, the lion will get up. So what you have to do is this. Of late, some people will be throwing some things into the yard. Right? So you'll be throwing some things, papers, rubbish, whatever, at the back of the yard. So some people are thinking otherwise, that you were the cause or you were among, or you throw something up, but it's not you. So what you have to do is bring in a controversy in the area. So you need to be praying against these boys around the area who throw something, whatever, they chew sugar cane and they will throw, whatever you call it. This time they're going to throw turrets, excuse me, things there. And to be very, very talented, because the way an anointing has come with the BTF, that they will throw rubbish on your house up. So start praying against it. You are the only one I know here, but that I don't know the house. Mm-hmm. Is this the wall around it? Mm-hmm. And I don't know what is happening there. So pray so that God will tell me. I know you are up and some people are down. So don't worry at all. But so they will say you threw the term. That's what they are thinking and they are examining. Anything they are planning, God will try to reveal it to us to tell you. So take care of yourself and pour oil from top to down. Keep pouring oil every day for 1 month. And let's see what God will do, so that those who are praying will stop. Hmm? Other than that, they say you should also come down and sweep the compound also. Like they have shed, you have to also sweep and whatever. And then if it gets worse, they say it's you. Confusion is coming. So rise up and never use anger to address them. Because you, I know, you are strong. You can fight, but you don't have to fight. God bless you. Thank you very much. That is left to be done in your life is about the past. Let the past go so that God could begin something new in your own life. Anytime you remember the past, you shed tears in your room. You are a very nice girl, you are growing, and everything is becoming normal. You are changing. Compare your old picture and now you have changed. Deliverance is ongoing now.
We haven't touched you, but God is working because He is in you. But you have to work on your mind to let the past go and then begin a new beginning with God from now. Of course, you have a bright future. Let the past go. The relationship between your mommy and daddy is gone. There's nothing you can do about that. How you want to, tough times are gone, but still you are surviving and you live longer too. Think about what God could do now for you. That's what is more important. Never think that you are alone. Don't consider that you are alone. Loneliness is a demon, but being alone is not a demon. So forgive and forget and think about the future, because blessings are getting close to you and God is about to do something great. The key word here is separate yourself from the past. About what you thought, if no, it's gone. And love yourself, like yourself, take yourself as the best friend. That's the healing. If you love yourself and take yourself as a best friend, you get a healing. God heals your heart, He heals you, and you are free. And money that you have been praying will be coming very soon. And as for marriage, I don't talk about it now. God wants to work on this so that He opens the door. The door is there. So give God time. Next year, you marry. What type of food you eat and then you don't grow? Why are you laughing? You don't grow. What? Kangaroo or crocodile is in your womb that eats everything. So you want to be fat like mama? Then forget about what I'm saying. But the man who wanted to marry you wanted a girl who is fat. So if you don't put on, the blessing will not come. If you don't put on, the blessing will not come. So you think being fat is a... No, that's how God made me. That's how I am. Don't be afraid because your family now, they are grown and they are big. So you are afraid that when you eat too much, you too be big. You keep standing. Thank you, Jesus of Nazareth. Yes, Mama, I want to speak to you briefly, and that is it. It's about this one. About a company that they establish association with the other people. God is concerned about you and Him. In the realms of the spirit, earlier on, God didn't want him to do this. After praying, because you WhatsApp me a long time, so it's like my spirit to follow. I've been following that and you for some time now, but it's not everything we are permitted to say until now. We say this at the end of it. Because we have been praying over the water, and the revelation keeps coming. It keeps coming. So, in the mind of God, God wanted a separate company between you and Him, so that the blessing will be huge. Be big. That's what God is expecting. But the people that He has drawn, not that the company is wrong. Some of them are not living right. And He is living right. You are living right. And God is offended. And the Lord said that He's allowing him to help him break through with this company. Let the lady sit down for 5 minutes and remind me to call her at the altar to pray for. Please let the lady sit down for some time for me. Please sit down. Thank you. So God wanted him from now to 5 years to break through, to get a big profit, to start something with him. The focus is you and him, not he and them. Some of them, he doesn't know them, even though some of them go to church, but some of them don't live right. So it's a mistake. So God is going to help him, the business to go on. And in 5 years' time, then even though he remains, but you have a separate one with you. So start organizing and you start something, and later you come back to support him. And then it becomes a family company. That is order of the day. That's what God is thinking about. The blessing is upon you already. And also doing company is not like now you are going to have money. No, you are blessed already. God has blessed the work of your hands. The blessings are with you, is with daddy, every now and then. But you have to do something for the money to be made manifest. That's why you're doing something. Not that you are in need of some money, no. So there's a realm you are in, you need to consider them. So you need to discuss with me and pray about it. And after 5 years, this is what you do. Two, before 5 years, from now going, a lot of blessings will be coming from other sources for you and for him. You can still manage and start something with you and make you the head of it, and you'll be supported. And then there'll be breakthrough here and then breakthrough here too. Then when here is empowered, then he can leave from here. Because here, after many years to come, there's no hope. That will not have a good standard there. Mm-hmm. So that's how you should think about. Some things are hard to talk, but you also want that the hard talk to be brought to you so that you discern and know the mind of God about what you are to do. So God is about to lift you, he's about to lift daddy, and money is coming. Lastly, daddy should not be afraid that with age, 60 years going, whatever, thinking that if I don't do something, I will suffer 17, 18, 19. No. You and daddy have laid a Christian foundation. Whichever way God could use to bless you and open some doors, you will do. God said, you will never starve, you will never be empty, you will never be hungry. Blessings are going to all overflow. So don't be afraid. Tell him, you and him should do what you have to do. But God wants to effect the work of your hands and bless you big. Because you will never go hungry, your kids will never go hungry. So don't be afraid of the future. Life threats. Afraid. Fear that if you don't do something, how could you be built? No. God bless you. May the Lord be with you. Be with you, mommy. May God empower you and empower daddy and bless the work of your hands. Jesus, mighty name. Thank you. Yeah, so I want to pray for you. Take my hand, put it on your wall. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, do it now. Anybody who operated something negative before the engagement, whatever the person did, Lord, let it go back to the sender. Whoever gave you a hug, and did something, I reverse it. That's a slave woman. Whoever did something against you, I will reverse it back to the sender. May your presence and anointing rest upon her. Break every yoke now. And I pray from this month, you are taking the seed. The curse is broken. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Thank you.